Hello everyone, welcome back to this session. So today in this session, we're going to start with how you can link two Docker containers, right? So basically, if you're launching multiple containers, and the next step that you would think about in the sense, how to advance the projects that you create in the Docker ecosystem, you would think, what if, you know, the two containers that I've deployed, they can communicate with each other and not via Docker volumes where you share files, but using a network, right? So for that particular thing, we have something, or we had something called as Docker containers linking, right? So you basically, what you do not create a network, or you do not deploy it in Docker Swarm. What you do is you just specify that this container should be linked with this particular container, and then the communication between them is established, and the IP addresses of each other's stay is mentioned inside their host file. So we are gonna see what linking Docker containers in this particular session. So let's go ahead and start with the session, guys. So guys, linking is basically a legacy feature of Docker, which helped us in connecting two or more containers, right? What basically at the back end, what happens is, if you link two Docker containers, IP addresses are assigned to these containers, and the each other's, so basically if there are two containers that we are linking, the containers IP addresses are mentioned in the /etc/host file, right? That they get added automatically when you link two Docker containers, right? And then you can communicate, these containers can communicate with each other basically using these IP addresses, okay? Now, how do you link containers? For that, we basically have a very simple command, and that command looks something like this. So you type in the syntax docker run -it, and then you type in --, link, the name of the container that you want to link it with, -d, and then the image name. Okay, so this is how you can link the name or link two containers. The most pivotal thing, or the most important thing for linking two containers, is the name of the container. So as you can see over here in this command, you can see that I'm running a container, say container one, and I'm naming it as --name. So this is how you define the name of a container, that is --name. Do you name the container, and the whole command after that remains the same. So --name is very important. So once I've defined container one, what I do is, when I'm defining container two, so this is container two, I named it as container two, I type in the command --link, and then I tell the container on which I want to link this particular container to. So for example, I want to link it with container one. So what I specify is --link container one, and then the rest command follows. Okay. So let's see how we can establish this, or how we can create this inside our Docker ecosystem. So I'll just jump on to my terminal, guys. So my terminal is this. Okay. So let me just clear the screen. Let me remove all the containers which are basically running right now. Docker ps -a -q, hit enter. Okay, so containers are deleted, and now let's go ahead and start creating our containers. So first, let's create a fresh container. Let's try with docker run -it, the name of the container, which is let's say it's container one, right? And then I specify the image name, which is Ubuntu. Okay, I hit enter. So this container is now created. Awesome. Now I start with defining my next container, which is docker -it --name. And then I give the name as container two. Then I specify --link. And now, with which container do I want to link container to? So I want to link it with container one. Okay. Then I specify -d, and then Ubuntu. Okay. So this, with this, my container is now successfully created. Now what I'll do, I'll just go inside my container two. So I'll type in docker exec -it, name of the container, bash. So I'm inside the container now. Now let me first show you the /etc/host file. Let me just cat this particular file. So as you can see, that a new entry with the container ID has been specified. So this is container two. Okay. So this container two is basically running on this particular IP address, and this is container one, whose Docker ID is this, and the IP address for that Docker container has also been specified in /etc/host. file. Okay, now I'm dead sure if you look at, so we have also have our second window open. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll just exit the container. Okay, let me duplicate this session, guys. Now what I want to do is I'll do a docker ps, and as you can see, so my container ID 56DE is basically mentioned over here, right? And this is container 2. 56DE is basically container 2. 7F0BA is container 1. And as you can see over here, container 1 is 7F0BA. And this is the IP address which has been assigned to it, through which 56BDE container, which is basically container 2, can interact with container 1. Okay, now how do I interact in my container? All I have to do is I'll have to say ping container 1, and with this my container would be establishing a network connection with container 1 and I should be able to communicate. But the problem is I don't have ping installed on this container. So if I hit an enter, it says ping command not found. So what I can do is I'll just type in apt get install. So let me just update the machine first. So apt get update. So my container is now getting updated. So using the ping command basically to verify if our containers are able to interact with each other. Now I'll type in apt get install ping. So I don't know the package in which ping is there, but this should basically give me an error in which it will specify where ping has to be installed from. As you can see, this is the ping package that I'll be installing. So I'll just specify apt get install, and then we'll specify this package. I'll hit enter. I hit Y and ping has successfully been installed now. Now what I'll do, I'll type in ping container 1. I'll hit enter. And as you can see, it is able to basically successfully communicate with container 1 from inside container 2 because we linked the two containers. Now I'll prove it to you that if you don't link containers, you will not be able to interact. So if I exit the container and if I run one more container of Ubuntu and I don't link it with basically anything, and now let's go inside the container. So docker exec hyphen it, the container ID, and then bash, right? So let's do the same thing again. I'll just type in apt get update, and then I'll type in apt get install ping. I'll get the package name from over here, apt get install package name. So ping is installed now. What I'll type in ping container 1. As you can see, it says container 1 name or service not known. Reason being, this container, this particular container, has not been linked with container 1. Okay, and that is the reason you're basically seeing this particular error. So any container which has to interact with the other container which is there, you have to link them, and only then they'll be able to connect with each other. All right, so guys, this was about linking containers. Now we did the hands-on as well, right? So let's summarize what all we did. So we created basically two containers of Ubuntu with the names container 1 and container 2. We linked container 2 to container 1, and we then tried pinging from container 2 to container 1 by using the command ping container 1. And we will successfully be able to see that when we ping, we basically get a successful message of the ping being able to reach the respective container. And if we do not link the containers, we also saw that the particular container on which we wanted to host it, if it's not linked with our container, is not able to interact in that case. Right, and this is what linking is, guys. So that's it for today's session, guys. Have a great day ahead and goodbye.